Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. This is our love song. Roughly translated, it means God, 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 God. God, Krishna, but Hare might mean me, Radha. The song is about two divine lovers, God and possibly me. Krishna came to our village. His blue-faced charm caught all the girls by surprise. We had been herding, washing, mucking, and milking, and our red-faced husbands were too busy eating the cows, dirtying the laundry, and making the babies to help. Krishna came to our village. He lit up the stars, disco ball bright, smoothed the cow patties to a dance floor sheen, and put on the music. We couldn't not follow him. We couldn't not dance. So we dropped the babies. We left the pots on the stove, picked up our dirty skirt hems, streaming with mud and breast milk, and ran towards the strange night magic, our red-faced husbands thick with sleep. He split himself into 108 identical Krishnas, one to dance with each of the girls. We turned our faces to him, weak in our dancing knees, in love. It lasted for weeks. One by one, the girls took his hand, insisted they come home. They said we could make a life together, share the herding, washing, mucking, and milking, but now with blue-faced charm, with extra night magic. And he would disappear in that moment, right in the middle of the box step. The girl would wake from her trance, dancing alone in a midnight field, hands held up where a man was once holding them. Girls asked, Krishna's disappeared, one after the other, until it was just me and him. I was 16. I'd never felt the sweetness of a kind man's touch. I'd never felt seen in this way, as if my skin didn't matter, like it wasn't a boundary between us. I didn't know that I could ask for anything so grand as a second date. In the stories, they exalt me as the one girl with the wisdom to stay present, because I didn't ask for more than I got. I didn't ask him to stay. So he leaves. He keeps on leaving anyway to do his godly things, and I, at home with my red-faced husband and 108 children, I, Radha, am your goddess of longing. She who turns her love to the butter churn, to the herding, washing, mucking, and milking. I have become a lesson to women everywhere in how to find joy in what you've already got, a cautionary tale about the dangers of wanting more. I think often of those women who broke the spell, who stepped out of the present for a moment long ago in that midnight field. What wild freedom sprung up beneath their feet when they found they were dancing alone. I wonder how things would have been different for me if I had only asked for more.